Somebody else.
We need to find a single guy. So.
All right.
No room for you. Enjoy.
Thank you.
All right.
Hi.
How's everyone doing?
Wow, you are the same guy that gave me a ride in the Model S back in March of 2009.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.
And you were explaining.
You remember me.
And here you are explaining again for Tesla Motors Club.
You know, it's crazy because I was telling people this really brings back memories back to that unveiling. This whole event, the way we're setting it up.
It was the same place.
Well,
it wasn't quite
SpaceX.
Exactly, yeah. Well, your little tent in the corner of SpaceX.
Yeah, but now we have this building, but I'm going to take you on the same road we did back then.
So now check at this roof.
Wow, yes, the roof.
I can't see it in the darkness,
Yeah, so the rear glass goes up and over your head, so you have a lot of headroom back there, and it gives you a greater sense of spaciousness in the back seat. So a car normally with this kind of profile would not have that much headroom, but since we have glass back there, you have more headroom than you normally would.
So you know, I'm gonna have to pair this video with our video from
back then,
from like 7 years ago.
Wow, you have a good memory. Okay, so we're gonna do a quick acceleration run here.
Whoa!
Okay, battery is down low.
Can accelerate, that's for sure.
It's not Model S or X speed, but it's still very fast.
It's fast enough.
And the battery is still down low, just like on S and X. So if you notice back there, the car cornered very flat.
So how about the screen? Mm-hmm. How large is the screen here? Is the same thing, 17?
No, this is a 15-inch touchscreen.
Oh, it's a 15.
We had to proportion it to
Are you really going to go landscape?
Yes, we are. The reason for that is we wanted both the driver and the passenger to have equal access to the information on the screen.
Oh, I see.
And, taking the binnacle away from the IP allowed us to put all that information in the screen, pushing the IP down lower, further away from the driver and the passenger, giving us a lot more room.
Right.
And then having a lower hood gives us greater visibility of the road.
Perfect.
But are you really gonna bifurcate, you're gonna have a whole different UI, you're gonna unify the UI between the different product lines?
That will have more information around production time.
And what's your name?
Bernard.
Thank you.
Huh?
Bernard.
Good to see you again,
good
Bernard.
To see you again.
I'm Doug. Take care.
Have a good day.
Can we see the trunk? Can you open the trunk?
There is some prototype hardware in the back, so it will be a little bit larger than that.
Is it going to have the push button like the
best?
Cool.
Just sits with me.